Gonna give my hair a little zhuzh and I'll be all ready for my night out. Hi, I'm Jessie Walker. I am a makeup artist and today I'm gonna show you how to get a gorgeous gold smoky eye, perfect for summer holidays or just a night out at home. So I've already done my base, but I'm gonna start by using the iconic London Glaze crayon in the shade Goddess. This is such a gorgeous kind of sparkly golden color. Look at those sparkles, amazing. And I'm just gonna draw this as if it were a pencil straight onto my eyelid. And then I'm gonna blend it out using my fingers. This is so nice and sparkly. You can probably catch that sparkle there. But because it's a cream shadow, it's also gonna give me that longevity because there's nothing worse than when you're on holiday, you've got your gorgeous smoky eye on, you're down by the pool, it's falling all over your face. We don't want that happening today. And by using one of these long wear sticks, it's gonna make sure that our makeup doesn't go everywhere, which is exactly what we want. So now I'm just gonna do the other side. Again, I'm just kind of sketching it on. You can see I'm not really dragging my eye, I'm kind of just sketching it on bit by bit. You can be really messy and imprecise with this too, which is great. You don't have to be an expert at makeup to use these products. And again, I'm just gonna take my finger and blend that out. And that'll give us already a really strong kind of glowing base for our eyes, nice and sparkly. You could actually wear this and head out, but because we're doing an evening kind of smoky look today, we can now build on it. Take this powder shadow palette from 17. This has got some absolutely gorgeous shades in it. I will show you. As you can see, you've got some great shimmers there. Great colors for kind of all skin tones, really. These colors would be amazing on deeper skin tones. And then you've got the more pinky shades if you're super fair. And we also have these matte shades too, which are great just for adding a bit of crease definition, smoking out the corners of your eye, smoking out your lash line. This is a really versatile palette. And this one is in shade 010 Golden. So we're gonna use that one now. I'm just gonna take a really simple blending brush and start working this shade into kind of the outer corners of my eye and my crease area. So I'm just kind of nestling the brush into my socket and really kind of blending that out. So simple, it doesn't have to be perfect. And the more of this you add, you can kind of build up that shade, get it really, really nice and smoky. You can already see the difference in how this is building up. Some nice warmth and definition. I'm just gonna do the same on the other side. And layering these products, so using your kind of creams, your liquids, anything long wearing underneath and then powdering it on top is gonna give it so much longevity and make it super heat proof and sweat proof. So I don't know about you, but so hard to keep makeup on those really hot days on holiday, but this will 100% help. So as you can see, we've got some really nice definition there. We've literally used two products, which is great. I really want to amp up the smoke now. So I'm going to grab a pencil. This is the number 7 Stay Perfect Eye Pencil. Again, this is like a long wearing formula, which is great. And this is in the shade brown. And I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna go all the way in through my waterline. So I'm applying this Stay Perfect number 7 brown pencil now. And the easiest way to apply pencil on yourself is to look straight ahead into the mirror. Use your little finger to slightly pull down, very slightly, pull down your kind of lower eye area so that you're kind of exposing that inner waterline, and then lightly kind of dragging the pencil along your waterline. And for looks like this, where we're doing a smoky eye, you can really kind of let it do its thing. You can let it smudge onto your lashes. You can let it smudge underneath. We're gonna take a smudgy brush in a minute and blend it out. So you really don't have to be perfect. I can't say enough. You really don't have to be good at makeup to achieve these looks. but also once these pencils are on, because they are long wear, we want to head in with a blending brush, and just before they set, as these will set in place, we're gonna just blend these out. And I'm just kind of taking windscreen wiper motions, I suppose you'd say, with a little blending brush, and I'm blending these out. And this is giving me a really beautiful smoky lower lash line. And then I'm just extending it slightly at the end to give me more of a feline shape. And you can see how much kind of smokiness that's added to the eye with just one more product, which is great. So now that we've finished the under eye kind of smoke out, you can see that's looking really lovely. And if you wanted something a little bit lighter, you could definitely leave it here, a bit of mascara, a bit of lip gloss out the door. But I really want to amp this up now because I've got a bit of a night out happening and I just really want my eyes to pop. So I'm gonna take that same pencil and I'm just gonna go above my lash line now. So I know this is a little bit tricky to do on yourself. So the best tip I can recommend you is take a handheld mirror and look down into it. So you wanna kind of tilt your head back and look down into the mirror, and then you'll be able to see the area that you wanna apply pencil to without having to close your eyes, because there's nothing worse than trying to do makeup with one eye shut, one eye open, just never works. So if you look down into the mirror, and I'm gonna apply a little bit now, I'm gonna start right on the inner corner of my eye. And again, I'm using those kind of sketchy motions because you never wanna drag your eyelid. It's not good for the skin. And you might hurt yourself, which is not what we want. So I'm just kind of sketching along my lash line. Again, you can be really kind of rough and sketchy with this because we're going to blend it in. And I'm just going to do the same on the other side. And you can see how much kind of intensity that adds. It looks amazing. But I'm just going to take my little pencil brush again and I'm going to start working this in. And again, I'm just kind of applying medium pressure and really buffing this out with my brush. You can always add more pencil and keep blending if you want to up the intensity. I might just add a little bit more in the corners. So that's just on the outer, I'd say, third of my lash line. Tends to keep your eyes a bit more open if you're keeping the darkest parts on the outer corner. That will lift your eyes up and out rather than closing them over, which is not what we want. And again, I'm just blending that out a little bit. It looks really, really pretty and smoky without kind of closing your eyes. And that looks great with the pencil. And just to intensify a little bit further, I am gonna take the dark brown shade in this NARS Voyager palette in Suede, this dark matte brown shade here, just to add that tiny bit more smokiness. So I'm gonna take that again on my pencil brush. There's no need to use like 50 brushes. You can honestly get this done with two or three. I always use my fingers as tools. You really, really don't need a million things to create beautiful looks. So I'm gonna take my little pencil brush again and that dark shade, and I'm just running it over where we blended the pencil. And as I described to you before, using the powder over the cream layers will just help to keep this really long wear, because that's what we want. We don't want smoky eyes all over our faces. So that's it layered over the bottom. And I'm just gonna take my other eye brush and layer that dark matte color in the corners over the pencil there too. So I'm just taking this just on the outside corner there. You can see you naturally kind of get a triangle shape there between the crease of your eye and your lash line. And that's where I'm really applying the product. Because again, this winged shape will really lift your eye up and out and give you that beautiful open kind of feline shape without being too complicated. So just taking a last blend there with everything. Now that looks nice and blended to me. But always check yourself from a few different angles, and if you can, have a look at your eye makeup in daylight, because that's where any errors or horrors are going to show. So have a look in the daylight, take your mirror out there, and you'll be sure everything's super blended. So I now want to amp up the glitter and sparkle on my eye, because I'm a big glitter and sparkle lover. I'm heading back to my iconic glaze crayon in Goddess, and I'm now going to head, so good that these are double-ended, I'm now going to head back to this kind of like bronzy sparkly shade. And this comes with a little doe foot applicator, that is so cute. It comes with a little doe foot applicator, and I'm just going to apply straight, oh my gosh, it's so sparkly. I'm going to apply straight on to my eyelid with this. This is honestly like liquid gold. Oh my gosh. I feel like an Egyptian princess. Perfect. So yeah, I'm just going to layer this over the top, and you can see the difference between my eyes there. That is amazing. And again, I'm just going to, if there's any harsh lines, I'm just going to not really blend, more just pat that color out. And this will dry, so it won't slide all over your face, which is what we want. That is so, so beautiful. I'm just going to repeat that on the other side. So I'm just layering this up now, popping a little bit more on the eye. This honestly is so metallic and beautiful. It's a really beautiful shade too. It's quite unique, and I think this would work really well on almost all skin tones. It's a really universal bronze, and I'm just patting that in. Well, gold, really. I'm just patting that in to the eye. Almost gives a gorgeous kind of wet look, doesn't it? So pretty. So I'm gonna add a little bit of mascara now just to finish this look off, and I am using Maybelline The Falsies Surreal Mascara because I really wanna add that bit of drama. If you're gonna wear a really heavy smoky eye, or not heavy, if you're gonna wear a strong smoky eye, you do wanna have a really nice thickening, lengthening mascara, because this is gonna keep everything in balance. And this one is absolutely gorgeous. Really gives you that kind of false lash effect, which is great. And you can layer this up as much as you want. You can leave it to dry and do another coat if you want. I'm also gonna head onto my bottom lashes. Excuse my mascara face. I'm gonna head onto the bottom lashes there. And you can see how that really just ties the whole thing together. Looks beautiful. And finally, I'm looking a little bit washed out on the rest of my face because I have this strong smoky eye and just a base on. So I am going to apply a little bit of this Bobbi Brown Pot Rouge for Lips and Cheeks in the shade Powder Pink. They do these in plenty of shades, so regardless of your skin tone, you'll be able to find something that gives you a gorgeous natural flush. So I'm just going to take this on my Real Techniques buffing brush, but you can use your fingers if you'd rather. And I'm just going to apply a little bit of this on my cheeks. I am kind of taking it higher up on the cheek, not so much on the apple, just to kind of stay in keeping with that feline or sculptural shape. And you can see just from the one side of my face how much that kind of lifts my complexion, makes me look healthier, like I've been in the sun. And then you can also just take that on your finger, and that can give me a lovely little kind of nude peach lip, which is beautiful. We live for a multi-use product. I don't want to be carting a massive makeup bag on holiday with me. So I'm going to take this gorgeous Kat Von D Dazzle Stick in the shade Electro Bowl. It's a kind of chromey, holographic, reflects a few different colors, sexy shimmery color. And I'm just going to take this on a little brush and I'm going to pop this on the inner corner of my eye. Look at that, that is incredible. So pretty. And just on the inside area of my lid, because I feel like this is going to, again, bring even more lightness to the eye. And I think that looks beautiful. And there we have the finished look. I'm looking gorgeous and glowing. I'm going to give my hair a shake. So I'm all ready for my night out. Don't forget to leave a comment down below if you give this look a try. I would love to see. And please like and subscribe to the Boots YouTube channel for more beauty tutorials.